Welcome, foolish mortals.
Hello, welcome to Magical Maidens Paranormal Blogs. Today I have something for you to ponder. Now, I'm not sure if this is true. I leave it up to you to decide. Make up your own mind. As always, do your own research, use discernment, and come to your own conclusions. So it has been said that there have been people turned into wax and used as mannequins. And there's a particular case, and it's funny because as I was working on this, several other people were coming out with the same thing. So see how the collective works when you're thinking about something, so do other people. You can affect other people because we're all connected. So Ariel from Twitter, this is the credit for him. He said that Balenciaga, and there's also something from Night God on YouTube, and there was also from The Darkest Secret on YouTube that had posted about a mannequin in the Balenciaga store in Paris. And so you remember the House of Wax, okay? And Ariel, this is from him, so I'm going to credit his post on Twitter or X. People do not know that when you walk past missing people that have never been found, that you might be walking past them because their embalmed corpse ends up in a shopping mall as a mannequin. And you think it's 100% made out of wax. So that's a thought to ponder. Now, it could be several things. They are not that good at wax. I mean, you could always tell. I mean, they are good at wax. Some are better than others, but you can always tell. And Ariel also said, do you know how many stories from all over the world where there are cases of missing people that were found embalmed and put out on public display? This is not new, he says. And even Hollywood makes movies to mock our ignorance, and they always do, and it's also called predictive programming. They got to show you what they are doing to us, what they've done to us, and what they plan on doing to us. And it's not because they care about us, it's because of the universal law of free will. They have to show you and tell you, but they do it in a way that only the awake and aware would know. And so you're basically giving your consent when you do nothing about it. They're evil, so they work with loopholes. They'll be like, well, we showed them, we told them over and over. And they use commercials and movies and ads of all kinds and magazines and books and billboards and you name it. They use it to let you know the truth about everything they've done to us, they're doing to us, and plan to do to us. But the thing is, you never would know if you're asleep. You would think this is just a movie, that is just an ad, that's just a commercial, that's just a billboard, that's just a book, that's not real, that's just a mannequin, that's just a wax doll. So there are hundreds of victims this has happened to. And there was one report Ariel talks about with the embalming room murders of Japan in the 1930s. And a series of murders took place in Tokyo, Japan, where the victims were killed and their bodies were embalmed and displayed in an abandoned building. The perpetrator was a medical student, and I cannot pronounce the name, Akira Nishiguchi, and was arrested and executed for his crimes. So you all have to stop and stop being so dismissive. He even says that. And like I said, Hollywood is not creating these stories. They are documenting them. That's true. And we all know, you know, you got to be careful. Hollywood sometimes does strange things. Like strange movies where you feel it's almost as if you're watching a real snuff film. And I wouldn't doubt that they wouldn't put clips from real. Now, I have no proof of this, But I wouldn't doubt for the realism and because they have to show and tell you that they wouldn't take actual clips from real snuff films that they've done, torturing and injuring people and killing people, and stuck it into their horror movies, and you wouldn't even know that that's what you're watching. That's what they do. And so while I can't prove that, I wouldn't doubt it. So the story gets even freakier because there is a woman, there is a shop in Mexico where there's this mannequin, and it is said that she's dressed in a bridal gown. I think she died and she was to be married, and I don't know if it was the mother or the father, but they couldn't stand the fact that their daughter was dead, and they basically used her body as a mannequin. And everyone says they believe it is real. I'd have to look for the story. I know they have those reborn realistic dolls, and I think they're kind of freaky. I know people are into that, and especially women that have can't have babies, they tend to do that. Buy those baby dolls that look real. They're called reborn baby dolls. They're very hyper realistic. And it's freaky to me. I don't like them. They give me a bad feeling because it's almost as if they're like the Cabbage Patch babies, not the dolls. There's a whole story, and if you go to Mine Unveiled, they have a series of different videos based on the Cabbage Patch and the orphans and so many things. You've got to look at Mine Unveiled. Now, I put the link. Unfortunately, I don't know what's going on with links. When I put links, they're non-clickable. People have told me. I didn't even know about this till someone messaged me in my comments and told me that some of the links, like on my Hidden in Plain Sight and Mud Fossils, they no longer work. So I've been looking into it, trying to fix that. But just go to Mind Unveiled and go check that one out. Also, go to Night God and check his channel out as well as Ariel on Twitter or X. So, what I'm thinking, there could be several things. Now, either the evil controller, elitist, so-called elitist, cabal of darkness have found a way to just embalm and encase an actual human in wax, because we know this has been done before, okay? But they look like they're still alive but trapped in there. So what I'm thinking that we all know they can make clones. And they have synthetic clones which are even there's certain different types, okay? And they feel waxy and look waxy, and that could be, it is said anyway, I don't know, I haven't met one. That could be that. And they're using actual clones of actual people because in like Balenciaga, it resembled a model, an actual model, but they said he's gone missing, he stopped posting on social media, and apparently they found him, he denies it. But some of them know that they're making clones of them. They sign up for it when they kind of sell their soul and sign up for fame and fortune. But some of them don't know. So either he knows that there's a clone of him or they don't. Now, what they can do is probably take the clone and unanimate them. So they're basically on hibernation, stuck on pause, and they actually use them. And that's why they're so hyper realistic, because they are almost human, because they're clones. Now, maybe they know, maybe they don't know that people are making clones of them and using them as real life mannequins. Okay? I'm not sure of that, but this could be a scenario where they're actually clones. Now, either they're on a hibernation mode, and or they're just shut down and they're just using the carcass of this clone, or they're actual humans encased in this weird wax, and they're in a trance, and they're actually alive, but they're in a trance of some kind, some black magic spell. You just never know. So there could be many theories. I mean, I don't know. Let me, go ahead and put in the comments what you may think. Again, these could be true. This could not be true. Like I said, use your own discernment, do your own research, and come to your own conclusion. Okay, so this is the model. I'm going to put the volume up.
This is a mannequin that they say that they made this shit and put this in the store. This boy look like somebody dead and bomb. Look at his hand. Wait, I'm doing it through the hole. Look at the boy hands. I swear, if anybody have this guy missing, if anybody have this guy missing, please. This is crazy. I've never seen anybody look so freaking real. How you have this man in a store? Sit down. Look. Look at that shit. You see? This is freaking crazy. Look in the guy's eye. And them said they made this mannequin. I put clothes on him and have him sit down in the window. Look at the guy friggin' face. This look like the friggin' guy who was in the school basketball court inside the school where them kill and take out him kidney.
But this has happened in the past with real humans, and there's a fact of it. So, and I read one out to you, and then there's that mannequin in Mexico. Okay, so there's a bridal shop, like I said, and I will probably butcher this name, Chihuahua, Mexico. Sorry about that. And it's said to be the daughter of the bridal salon owner. And it's very creepy. Her hands have fingerprints and her nails look real. And only one person is allowed to change her and dress her behind a curtain. And people in that town seem to think that is the daughter because it's an urban legend, and it's the dead body of the daughter of the former shop owner. So they really think that this is real, and it could be. I don't know. Unless you take these things and are allowed to dissect them and find out if they're human or not, you're never going to know. We can only speculate. So it's been an interesting story for many, 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 many years. Ariel said there was a report out that showed people that this was an option for cremation. So it definitely is a thing, but they will never guess as to why. A certain person kept mentioning this, especially regarding the missing children. Okay, a certain president that was president with the initials DT kept mentioning this regarding the missing children. Okay. Now remember the movie Mannequin where they showed she was real? It was a stupid movie from the 80s, but nonetheless, they have to show and tell you. It's up to you to figure it out. Okay. And it was ridiculous, but this is what they do. And Ariel goes on to say that you think this practice is new and this is normal, but all you have to do is look up this one case with, and again, pronouncing this Zhangweijie. She came up missing and was found as a wax figure in an exhibit. So you really don't know, he even said, how diabolical these people are. They are. They are disgusting. They are sick. They are twisted. They are extremely dark and do horrific things and have done horrific things to humans. And they'll continue as long as they exist. So if you think that, you know, this isn't real, well, that's okay. That's your opinion, and everybody's entitled to your own opinion. But it really makes you wonder, and it really makes you think. And it's very creepy, and it bothers me. And since I'm clairaudient, I think what I might do is have also a pendulum session asking questions about these. And I'm going to also have a sit-down conversation, and maybe I'll get some EVPs, and I'll make another video. In the meantime, go ahead and check out Ariel on X and A-R-E-I-L. And check out Night God's video. I'm telling you, it's a lot of sick, twisted things going on there. So what do you think about this? So it's a dark and scary and disturbing road that you have to go down to find out certain things. And this is one dark rabbit hole that some might opt out on, not going down. And when you go down this rabbit hole, keep an open mind. Don't just pish-posh it away and say, oh, this can't happen, this has never happened, because it's actually been documented to have happened in the past, like I said. So, evil people do evil, disturbing, horrific things to others. And they've been doing it. And I'm not really sure if it is just clones or a combination, because like I said, they have done this to humans. So they have technology that they've kept secret from us. That's not a secret. That's not anything new that we don't know. Most of us know they have kept technology suppressed, probably 1,000 years worth. And they give us drips and drabs of it, but the inferior versions, and charges way too much for it all. And who's to say they can't put a human in suspended animation? So they are aware that they're suspended, they're aware of the surroundings, and they could be kept alive while encased in a wax or synthetic clones type skin. And they can't do anything about it. They're stuck in there. Now that is a pure living hell. Can you only imagine how torturous that is? And they love torturing humans. Remember, they have, let's just say, places that where they take people and hunt them. Okay? They have hunting parties. And I can get more descriptive. I'm not going to go into it here. They showed it on movies because, not because it's just a movie, it's because they have to show and tell you what they've done, what they're doing, and what they plan on doing to us all. So, you can look into it further. Do, like I said, use discernment, do your own research, and come to your own conclusions. And I'll put the links below for Night God and for Ariel on Twitter, and you can read his post. I'll try to put some of that there on the bottom of this video in the description box. Hopefully the links will show up. I'll put the link to Night God's video that he did. I'm going to try to find the one from The Darkest Secret, because she did a video of it as well. And you can check out those channels as well as those videos. There's something about this. And I am going to look into it further. And like I said, since I am clairaudient, I will ask. And I will do a pendulum. I will do a pendulum on this reading about it as well. And then when I have time, do a video. So this is very intriguing and interesting. It's also very horrifying. It's also very horrifying and disturbing. But when you think about it, you know, it doesn't feel too far-fetched if you know the things that they're capable of and the things they have done in the past that were horrific. What's to say they have not done this and will continue to do this? And you're walking by missing people, and to their amusement, they're stuck and they're in a suspended animation. And they see you and they can hear, and but they can't do a thing about it. They're trapped in their own encased body with whatever they do to them. Now, this could just be clones, and they're unanimated as well, and they can reanimate them at any time. And the same with the people, they probably can. I don't know. I'm just speculating again. I have no idea. I have no conclusive anything unless somebody takes these mannequins and dissects them and can tell. There's no other way to know. And I believe that some of the famous people or whatever know that they do this and have consented to them using their clones for this, or they didn't consent to it and do know about it. Or don't know a thing about it. And they probably do use clones of famous people and humans that have been missing. And there's these disturbing, in that video that I got shows you, they the disturbing, I don't even know what, displays of supposedly mannequins in airports. Why are they in airports, number one? Were they whistleblowers? Did they do something to piss one of them off? Are they just a missing person? And they're doing this as their form of punishment. So they are in suspended animation. They're aware that they're stuck as a display, and that's their punishment. Could you imagine? That's worse than that's any hell. That's a purgatory. And so you got to watch that video. I don't like using anybody else's content without their permission. Okay, so I can show you that other thing, but as far as anything else, go watch Night God's video and check out Ariel's thread on X. So again, look for the links below, and I will be back with more on this when I find out more information. So thanks for watching. And again, remember, if you're not subscribed, go ahead and subscribe and click that notification bell so you're notified when I upload my latest content. I hope you will share and like this and comment if you have any questions or know more about this or want to share your thoughts on this. Okay? And again, I'm not saying anything is factual except for what I do know is factual. And you can come to your own conclusions. Thanks for watching. See you in my videos. Bye.